Hey there, my name is Dan Scott, and this is one video from my larger Adobe XD course, which you can check out on bringyourownlaptop.com. You can also go there to download the free exercise files and the free cheat sheet if you like. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there, in this video, we're gonna look at symbols in XD. Okay, so why are they good? It's because when I've got a symbol, you can see here I've got the navigation used on more than one page, and when I update it, they both update and change, which is super helpful for things that are reused across lots of documents like footers and headers. Let's go and look how to create those now. Okay, to create a symbol, we're going to reuse this, both this header and the footer. So I'm gonna create a new page, and there's lots of ways, and I keep showing you different ways. I'm gonna go back to the page tool and click on this, which is my default that I used at the beginning. I'll drag it by dragging the name underneath. I'm gonna give it a name. I'm gonna call this one the instructor dashboard. Okay, and I wanna extend it out just a little bit. Cool. So remember, the benefit for using a symbol is I can connect them all together, and when I make updates to the navigation, say on this homepage here, it'll update for all instances of it. Okay, so I'm going to zoom in here. What I want is I want all of this. So I'm starting up here in the gray area with my black arrow. I'm just clicking, holding and dragging just all across this like top little bitty bit. Okay, and what I want to do is, you can see I've selected lots, but I've also selected this like blue thing that I'm using to kind of give me my widths. So I'm going to hold shift and just click on him to get rid of him. So I've got everything along the top here. How do I know? I kind of just drag it off to check. They all came along for the ride. So what I'm going to do is, you might be on your layers panel. Okay, you want to go to this top one here. Okay, the assets panel. Within here, something called symbols, click plus, and that's it. That is now a symbol that I get to reuse. Okay, so let me click, hold, and drag it. Okay, and that's useful, I guess. You know, I've got a nice little thing that I get to reuse. But I could have copied and pasted that, I guess. And what's really useful is now if the client comes back and says, actually, you've spelled login, like some people use login as one word. It should be two words. Okay, it's up to you. But let's say we've been convinced it should be log space in. So we've done that, okay. But by default, it actually becomes a unique symbol. So this one up here has not changed yet. So what we need to do is right click this fella and say, update all symbols. Okay, it updates the symbol in the library. I'm gonna have to zoom out. This one here, command 3 to zoom in on it. Zoom in a bit more. And you can see it's login. Okay, so that is the perk for symbols. You get to link them to this thing so they're easily drag out and reusable. But what's really super useful is you get to update one and update them all. So obviously good for navigation. Okay, anything that appears on all the pages. So I'm gonna do the same down here. I'm gonna grab you, my friend. I'm gonna shift click this guy. So I've only got this selected. Just check that I've got it all. And I'm gonna go symbol. You can't name them yet. Okay, and the icons are a little bit small for this one. It's okay. And is this the right page? It is. Drag them on. Come here. And there you go. Okay, so if I update one now, they'll both update. All right, a couple of things I want to do to finish this off is I want to put that big blue kind of stripe in the background so I know where the edges are. So you copy and over here, paste. Wrong one. Okay, so I want you and go to unlock it. Copy it. I'm going to lock it again. And then come over here, click on this dashboard. And if you hit paste, the cool thing about it, it goes perfectly where it should, okay? The only trouble is it's probably on top of everything else, okay? So I'm just gonna right click it and say, send to the back. And then I can either use Command L or Control L, or I can right click and go lock. Cool. All right, so that gives me my boundaries. What I need now is a left-hand menu. So I'm looking at my hand-drawn wireframe here. Okay, so I want that left nav, and I'm gonna jump out to this thing here, and I'm gonna find a left-hand nav. Where can I see one? There's a navigation over here that looks good. He's gonna be my starting anyway. Cool, so I'm gonna grab you. Awesome, copy it, drag it across, paste it, and that'll be my starting for this one. I'm gonna ungroup it all, because there's a few things that I need to do. I need to put you to the bottom. I might have to tidy that up in a little bit. And I don't need the word XD there. Come here, they're quite hard to click. Okay, I do want the word dashboard. So I am going to probably delete you, delete you, delete you, delete you. Move you to the top. I'm going to make this the word dashboard, but I'm gonna use my 14. I'm at 75%. It's a bad habit. You've got to be at 100 so you can do your font sizes. Okay, this one's going to be dashboard. Dashboard. And I will make this bold. Cool. Underneath here, actually, I'll make that 16. I'm using 12 and 16 to kind of differentiate heights. Now, what I'll do also is grab my type tool, click in here. I've got some text for, this is the text that we're going to use. Where's my, this guy there? I'm mumbling now because I'm just filling in fonts. And to be honest, if there's going to be any more genius in this class that you might want to hang around for, I think I'm out of genius. Okay, so I'm just putting these in. What I might do is just put the little dots in the front to make them look like a submenu. You remember there I am putting in, it's holding Alt and hitting 8, or Option 8 on a Mac. Sorry, on a PC, because this doesn't have bullet points to start with. Cool, so dashboard, you, for the different things you can choose. Awesome. And one last thing that's on my little hand-drawn wireframe here is I've got that little ad from the home page. Now, there's not a really easy way to jump between pages. Okay, you can use your layers panel, go back to here and go back to home page. It's not that great, I don't think. Hopefully one of the upgrades will give us a feature like that. So here, I'm not sure why I came back for this bit of text, but I did. So we're going to use it. Let's go into here, come on three, zoom in a little bit more, paste. Okay, and it's going to go in this little area here. Now, I think this needs to be bigger because I'm going to have longer names in there, definitely. Cool. That's my little download the app thing. Maybe even smaller. There is actually zero genius coming. All right, the last thing we're going to do is, because we're going to use this across all of the instructor pages, we're going to turn it into a symbol itself. So we're just going to drag a box around all of this, deselect the lighter blue color, and say add symbol. All right, that's going to be it for this video. If you've waited to the end, you are awesome. That got a bit painful there at the end, I know. But the next video is going to be awesome. We start doing repeated grids. Oh my goodness, it's awesome. Let's go and do that now in the next video. Haerera. Hey there, please like the video. Consider subscribing to my YouTube channel as well. If you want the full course for Adobe XD, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. That's it. Bye now.